Welcome to Friday Night Special, Friday Night Bible Club. We're going to sing lots of songs, a few new songs, and then we're going to tell you about three interesting people. The first martyr, the first Christian in Europe, and also the first pastor. You're going to learn all about it. Let's sing a few songs.
Let me tell you
the Lord, be thankful to the Lord, praise Him. Jesus loves me, this I know. How do you know? For the Bible tells me so. You'll notice one week we're writing about every day. Next week we're doing a Bible story. All week then we're writing about, and we're going to go out and about again tonight. To give you an example, and if you pray, really appreciate you praying as we go out and about, get ideas to make Bible videos, education, most of all to evangelization, the salvation of children. But we're going to go now to overlook a city. I wonder if you can spot the city. And we're going to tell you a little story about the city in the distance. Ready? Here we go!
Boys and girls, does anyone recognise the view behind me? I'll give you a clue. It's a city, and it's a capital of a country, and it's a country called Northern Ireland, and it's Belfast. We're just outside in the hills of Belfast, Craigatlan, and outside in the outskirts. And if you notice carefully, it's a wee bit smoggy today. It's difficult to see. It's not so clear. But nevertheless, it's the city of Belfast. You can see the hospital, the city hospital, and the dome. There's a dome there. That's Victoria Square, the big shopping centre. And then, if you notice over to the this side, does anyone know what the big yellow things are? That's Harland and Wolff, the shipyard. But whenever I thought about a city, whenever I travel, I do like to travel, and sometimes I like to go up over the hills and you can look at the city. Then you would look at the specific landmarks. For example, there might be buildings, there might be statues, there might be shopping centres, or there might be water, little pools or monuments or something connecting that city. But whenever I think of Belfast, it's the capital of Northern Ireland, and many people travel to the centre for work or for studying or for shopping or for different reasons. But in the Bible, the Lord Jesus was standing in a city in the Bible in Israel at that time was called Jerusalem. And the Lord Jesus would often take himself off to be alone, to pray, to take time to talk to God. And the Lord Jesus is a great example for us to follow. It's always good to spend time alone with God. Whether you're in your bedroom or in the kitchen or at home or at school, you don't have to go to a specific place to talk to God. You can talk to God anywhere at any time, and he always has an ear to listen. And the Lord Jesus goes up into the mountain alone, and there he is, and he's looking over Jerusalem, the city, and he began to cry. And he says, "Oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, I called you to come to me, but you keep walking. You can't see me, you can't hear me, and you don't even want to follow me." And the Lord Jesus was really hurt by this, because he said, "I've come to call you to repentance, to save you, so that you can be with me forever in heaven." And the people didn't really care. And he loved the people so much, he began to cry because they would not come to him. And he says, "As a hen gathers her chickens, the same way I come to gather you. When a mother hen calls a little baby chicks, they come running under her wings, and she protects them and takes care of them." The Lord Jesus said, "That's why I came to save you, to take care of you, to protect you, to look after you. But you keep walking, you're away from me." Then on another occasion, the devil, he takes the Lord Jesus up into a mountain. And he says, he got these stones. And he said, "If you really are the Son of God, command that these stones just like that," he says, "command that these stones be made into bread." You can't eat that stone. So the devil said, "Make it into bread." But the Lord Jesus said, "Get behind me, Satan. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God." And Jesus kept saying, "It is written." He kept referring to the word of God, the Bible. And that's why the Bible is so important. And that's why it's important to read it, to learn it, to meditate upon it, to listen to stories about it, because it teaches us about God and how we can follow God. Then the devil took Jesus up into a mountain overlooking a city. And he says, "Bow down to me, and the whole city, all the cities of the world, every town, city, and village will be yours if you bow down and worship me." And the Lord Jesus said, "Satan, get behind me." And he says, "It is written." And there was no way ever the Lord Jesus was going to bow down to the devil, the god of this world, because the Bible says, "Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world." And boys and girls, if you've got the Lord Jesus, he is the greatest person you can ever know, and he's the most powerful person we can ever get to know. And he's so big, yet he can fit in your heart. How do you explain that? God is so big, our God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing he cannot do, yet he wants to fit in your heart, he wants to fit in your life, and he wants to live there, and he wants to steer you and guide you and correct you, and he wants you to praise him, and he wants you to have joy in your life and to really, really love life. And as you go through life, he says, "I want to help you. I want to help you to sleep at night. I want you to help you to study, to learn, to do your schoolwork, to do your homework, to be able to run, to be able to happy, to be able to play." And so that's a lesson. Whenever I saw the city, I thought that reminds me, one, of when the Lord Jesus looked at all the people and they didn't care. And many cities in the world, they don't care about God. They don't want God. They just want to do their own thing. But the Bible says one day the Lord Jesus will come back, and at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Because once he goes back, they're going to know, but it's going to be too late then to follow God, to worship him, to ask him to forgive you. That's why the Bible says now is the day of salvation, whenever we should think about God and trust in the Lord Jesus. He's a wonderful God, a wonderful Savior, and he's interested in you, in your life, and in your heart, and everything you're doing.
Did you recognise the city? It was Ballymena.
No,
Ballymena's not a city. It was Belfast. Yes, you got it. Belfast. And what wonderful lessons about we learnt there now. Let's sing Father Abraham. Yes, remember that one? Story. But before that, don't forget next week it's December, and every assembly from now on in school at your assembly we are going to do give out prizes. There's going to be prizes for the best class. If your class listens to assembly, tell your teacher to let me know and you will enter the competition for a prize. And for the prize, you're going to be, every child in a classroom will win a free book, one of our free books, one of our latest books. Yes. In the meantime, let's pray before we come to the story. Father, thank you for your word today. Thank you, Lord, for the opportunity of sharing the gospel, the Bible, with so many boys and girls across the country, even to many parts of the world. They tune in, they listen in, they love to learn and sing the lovely songs. Bless your word now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God's plan we're going to talk about. What's the three things we're going to talk about? The first Christian martyr, the first pastor that we read about, and Europe's first convert. It's all in the book of Acts, in the book we learn about Paul's life story, and we're going to learn about this. Well, God's plan, this is when God speaks. See, God speaks to us through his word. Boys and girls, if you don't read your Bible, don't listen to Bible stories, you're not going to hear from God. He doesn't speak with a big loud voice to your ear like I would. No, he speaks through his word and through the preaching of his word. And God would speak to Paul and to the evangelist to say, go and preach. And the Lord Jesus has ascended back into heaven. He tells his disciples to go to the upper room, to wait there until they are filled with the Holy Ghost, with power from heaven. And there was like flames on their head. And off they went preaching the word of God. And they absolutely love preaching. They love the word of God. They love people. Nothing was stopping them. People were full of fear, but they were full of the Holy Ghost to go and to preach. You see, some people try to live the Christian life on their own strength, but you can't do that. You need the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit to be within you, upon you, to help you to live for the Lord Jesus. And off they went. And as they were preaching the word of God, people were listening very intently, were being convicted of their sin, and they wanted to become Christians. They wanted to get converted. Yes, little children, older people, adults, grandparents. And off they went, living the Christian life from home to home, family to family, village to village, town to town, city to city, big groups of people, individual people, children, older people, preaching the gospel, telling the people they must repent of their sins and how Jesus has come and he's paid the price on the cross, how they can be forgiven. Yes, it was wonderful. But boys and girls, there's a problem. Because the religious leaders, they did not believe in this Jesus. And many people were getting converted and were not listening to religious leaders. They thought they're still waiting for Jesus to come. And all the apostles said, he has come. We worked with him. We lived with him. We witnessed him die and rise again. And he's told us to go and preach. We're not going to stop. And he said they started to beat up these Christians and put them into prison and told them, stop using the name of Jesus. But the more they punished him, the more they persecuted them, the more they kept preaching the word of God. And boys and girls, many people were loving the Christian life, were living out their Christian life, were shining for God, were helping others and looking after the widows and the poor people, as we should, always caring for one another. And one of those disciples was called Stephen. Bible says Stephen was full of faith and full of the Holy Ghost. And they brought Stephen in and accused him. And Stephen was full of knowledge about God, and he stood up, and he started in Genesis and went right through the patriarchs. Like, he talked about Moses and Abraham and Jacob and Isaac, and how God promised, because of the sin in the Garden of Eden, he would send his son. And God promised through these people he would send his son. And he said, his son has come, called Jesus, the one you crucified, the one you put to death. Whenever he said that, they were so angry. Do you know what they done with Stephen? Bible says Stephen, not only was he full of faith in the Holy Ghost, Stephen's face shone like an angel. The boys and girls, do you know what they done with Stephen? They took him out and they stoned him to death. Stephen became the first Christian martyr. A martyr, somebody died for their faith. His faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, his faith in God, his belief in the Bible, he was stoned to death just for being a Christian. And before he died, the Bible says he lifted up his head and he said, Father, forgive them. So he didn't realize what they were doing. These religious leaders should have known better, but they were so angry because he preached the name of Jesus. And thousands and millions of people since Stephen has been killed or put in prison or punished, persecuted because of their faith in the Lord Jesus. Today, boys and girls, it's easy to be a Christian. In fact, it's so easy, most people miss it. God often allowed persecution to come so people can flee to God and run to God. But most people can't see it, and many of them don't even want to see it. But boys and girls, if you realize you are a sinner before God, I urge you, I pray you'll run to God. You'll plead for God to come into your heart and your life and to save you and to make you one of his children, and you can live for him. That was Stephen, the first Christian martyr. Here's Saul standing, holding on to the coats, watching what's happening. He wants permission. He gets permission to go to Damascus. Then we're going to learn about Paul's conversion. And off he goes from Jerusalem to Damascus. And on the way, he fell down on his knees. He was blinded. A big, bright light shone down from heaven. And he said, Lord, who are you? And the voice of the light spoke and said, my name is Jesus. It's hard for you to kick against the pricks. And that, boys and girls, was a great moment in Saul's life, because there and then he got converted. A religious leader who hated the name of Jesus, who was now going to be persecuted by the very people he belonged to because of his love for the Lord Jesus Christ. But he never stopped them. The Bible says, if any man or child be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things pass away. Behold, all things become new. And Paul was now a new creation in Christ Jesus. The old life, and you get converted, and now you live for Jesus, and then you're going towards the new life. The old life, you turn around, and that's called repentance, turning from your sin towards God, towards a new life. Read about it, 2 Corinthians 5:17. We need to believe in what the Lord Jesus, not what he's doing, but what he's done on the cross. Paul, Saul, who became Paul, had to escape in a basket because the religious leaders were so angry and hated him so much for preaching about Jesus. And then God says to Paul, you are now entering the mission field. You're no longer your own. The Bible says you're bought with a price, the price of Jesus when he died on the cross and shed his blood. And Paul fully surrendered to following God and serving him all of his days. And very often he was put into prison. He was shipwrecked. He was beaten up. But he kept shining and living for God. And what a challenge even to some of the jailers. Prison keepers got converted because of their witness and their life in the prison. See, God has a plan. And God's plan was to send Paul to many countries, many islands, many villages and towns and cities to proclaim and to preach the gospel. Many people were getting converted all over the world. And one of these, as a second point, was a young pastor. This is Timothy. Timothy was taught by his grandmother who knew and loved the Lord. He was taught by his mother who knew and loved the Lord. And then he was trained by Saul who knew and loved the Lord. And Timothy became a preacher of the gospel, a teacher of the word of God, a pastor in the local church. In the Bible, two of the books of the Bible are called 1st and 2nd Timothy. These were letters written by Paul to Timothy. But boys and girls, today, many grandparents don't know the Lord. Many parents, mothers and fathers do not know God, are not Christians. Just like Timothy was taught by his grandmother, Timothy was taught by his mother. What a challenge for grannies and grandies and parents to teach their children. But if you're a child and your parents maybe don't know about God, you turn it around and you teach them the way of salvation. Teach them the way to God is only through Jesus, because Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Wonderful account how Timothy became one of Paul's first pastors and preachers of the word of God. He would spend time traveling and learning, and then once he learned it, off he went on his own to preach the word of God. And that's the way it is. God always needs workers. And the moment you give your heart and life to Jesus, God's plan, God's will kicks in for your life. Don't wait for it. It starts right now upon the moment of your conversion. And if you're not a Christian tonight, it can be a wonderful time. You can just get down on your knees, bow your head, and realize you're a sinner and ask God to forgive you, to save you. And right tonight, God's plan, God's will can start from this moment. And you can be a shining light just like Timothy. To live for him, to shine for him, to preach for him. Don't wait till you're old. Timothy was a young boy when he learned all about it, when he trusted in God. Now when he's older, he's able to travel and to be a preacher just like Paul, just like the Apostle Paul. Paul had visions. He had dreamed. And he dreamed, this is our third point, he dreamed there was people in Macedonia and Europe saying, come over and help us. The moment morning came, he jumped out of bed and straight over to Europe, to Philippi, crossing over to a different continent now. And he comes across a group of people, of children, and mainly women. And he begins to tell them who he was and how he loved God, how he's a preacher of the gospel. And then these people were hungry for God. They were praising God, but they didn't know Jesus. So many people worship God, but they don't know Jesus. I and my Father are one. Jesus is God, Father, Son, Holy Ghost. You can't know God unless you know Jesus. You can know about him, yes. But you can't know him in a personal way without believing in his Son. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible says, and thou shalt be saved. You will be saved. And as Paul's preaching, Acts chapter 9, verse 14, it's a lovely account. As Paul began to preach, you know what the Bible says? God opened Lydia's heart. In other words, he softened her heart. And as she listened, she began to realize she was a sinner. And did not know Jesus, didn't know God the way she should. And not only did the Lord open her heart, she listened. God opened her heart, and then she attended unto those things spoken by Paul. So boys and girls, faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the word of God. Paul preached, she listened. And then God did a work in her heart by opening her heart, but she needed to respond and say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Help me to be a Christian. She didn't know what to do on her own. She attended. She spoke to Paul. He prayed with her, explained to her. And many people, boys and girls, they listen. but they don't get converted. Many people, the Lord softens hearts, but they don't get converted because they don't attend all of those things. They don't come through for God. So tonight, right now, if you're listening to the Word of God and you realize your heart's soft and you know you're a sinner, you know you need God, be like Lydia. Be wise. Be like Timothy. Just pray and ask God to save you. Into my heart, into my heart. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come in today. Come in to stay. Come into my heart right now, Lord Jesus. Do you know what happens when that happens? The Bible says in the presence of all the angels in heaven, they are rejoicing. That means every Christian that has gone before, millions of them are rejoicing together with the angels because someone has just become a Christian. Come to God's family. And one of that one person is going to be you. Thus, we talked about the first Christian martyr was Stephen. Then we talked about one of the first Christian pastors was Timothy. And now this was Lydia. Lydia was a busy woman. She was a wealthy woman. She was a seller of purple. But she was willing to take a break from her wealth, a break from her busyness, and just to come and to listen to God's word. And God got her attention. Maybe she was too busy before, but God got her attention, and she was wise. She responded. When she heard the call, when she heard the knock, she opened and said, Lord, come in. And that's the way it is. Don't wait till you're older and you're busy and life's fast. Take advantage when you're young. See, like as a little child, listening to every word, wanting to give your heart and your life to the Lord Jesus and live your life for him. You might not be a preacher like Paul or a wealthy person like Lydia or a pastor like Timothy or a martyr like Stephen, but you can still live your life and shine for God all the days of your life. And best of all, it's not just about going to heaven. It's not just about staying the streets paved with gold. It's about being in the presence of King Jesus, Lord of Lords and King of Kings, every day of eternity. And there's no end in eternity, just a beginning. Wonderful. Then off he went preaching and preaching and preaching, and many people got converted, some people didn't. And it's all about believing. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Acts 16, verse 31. Paul's life wasn't all sunshine. Very often he was shipwrecked, put into prison. But you know what he done, boys and girls? He kept shining for God. But you can become a Christian doesn't mean you're going to have a perfect life. You might have, but you might not have. The difference as your life goes on, there's somebody within your heart and your life who goes with you throughout all of it. And that's the Lord, because he promises, I will never leave you. And that's a great promise. Should we do a quiz? What about carrots? We've had carrots for a while. Carrots, the crazy carrots. This is a good healthy quiz. And before we start eating selection boxes at Christmas, we'll have some carrots. Yes. Girls against the boys. Girls, I talked about a martyr tonight, somebody died for the Christian faith. What was his name? Stephen, that's right. Stephen for the girls. What have we got, girls? 30. Boys, what do you call the young pastor in the story? Timothy, that's right. Timothy, 4. I think the boys need to win tonight. That'll be good if they did. For a change, girls are winning already. Girls, Paul wrote how many letters to Timothy in the Bible? There are how many letters to Timothy? 2. 1st and 2nd Timothy. We'll go for 11. Nice white shiny teeth. 90. Looks like the girls are in for a win tonight. Well done, girls. But it's not over. Boys, when Paul was on the road to Damascus, what did he see? And what shone upon him? Was it a light? Was it a torch? What was it? A bright light. That's right. 6. Come on, boys, you look big. Oh, no teeth. But it's 80. Oh, what's a good score. Well done. Girls, when Paul said, Lord, who are you? The voice came back and said, I am Jesus. Well done. So far, so good. Oh, not so happy. 20. Ha. Girl, boys rather, it's a very even quiz tonight. Boys, you can tell me in the story we talked about Paul as he travelled. How did he travel from island to island? Was it an airplane, a big truck, a tractor, motorbike, bicycle, or boat? Boat. Yes. 7. Perfect number. Is it a perfect score? It's happy. And it's 150. Ha ha! Yes! Yes! It's Cream of the Girls are getting beat! Ah! Sorry. But it actually is Cream of the Girls are getting beat. Just saying, being honest. But the girls will probably still win, but they might not. Girls, tell me the answer to this question. Who was the first convert in Europe? Lydia, well done. 1, let's go for the start of the beginning. Don't need a calculator for this one. Oh, 60, well done. I need a calculator to count these. Girls, boys, Lydia's job was to sell material. What colour was that material it was? Purple, yes. Learning a lot tonight. 8. One, boys, another good score. Ha ha! Yeah! Girls, we could just stop now, Nate. You go to bed early, you're going to be asleep. Ha ha! Because I don't think you're going to win tonight, just saying. Well, we'll keep going. Girls, Lydia, it says 3 things about her. She listened and God was softening her heart. Did she become a Christian or not? Yes, she did. She called upon the name of the Lord. Wonderful. 2. 2 for the girls. 40. Boys, so Lydia became the first convert in Europe. Stephen became the first martyr. And Timothy. What 2 people did we learn about taught Timothy about God? His grandmother and his mother. Wonderful. What are responsibilities for grannies and mothers and grandas and fathers? 70. Take it away. Don't even need to count this. Easy win for the boys, I reckon. Girls, I can even give you the last 2. Boys, it might still win. Last one, girls. Somebody wanted to become a Christian, they must ask God to take away their what? Their sin. Wonderful. 9. 9. I'm feeling very generous. I'm going to give this to the girls as well. Boys, we don't mind super dumb. Girls, when you ask God to forgive you, take away your sin, you become a what? A Christian. Right, girls, I'm going to give you this extra one. Don't think I've ever done this before. Bit risky. Whew, 50. Ready to go now, that's it real quick. We've got 120 and 170, 190, 250, 340. 340 for the girls. Oh no, what have I done? Oh no. Okay, 0, old school counting, 8, 9, 14, 21, 21, 3. Made a mistake. Girls, you won the quiz. Don't know what happened there. Girls, I gave you an extra point and you won. But boys, we'll be back next week, all being well. Wonderful. Right, let's sing a song. And then we sung, I am a Christian. Remember that one? Yes, let's sing it together. Just for fun, ready? Here, yes, don't forget we're back on Sunday school 10:30, and we're going through the books of the Bible, a Bible verse every week. Really good time, really enjoying school assemblies every morning, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, 9 o'clock, and then Friday night Bible club at 7 o'clock. And that's it. Don't forget next week we're going to go through the life of Paul for the children of school, and we're giving out prizes to classes every single day next week. All right, any questions, you need to contact us, you can do that. by email or messenger, or here is the WhatsApp. Any questions or queries or anything they got? Let's pray. Father, we thank you for Bible Club tonight. We thank you for the lovely story of Paul, how Stephen suffered for our faith. We thank God for people like that, for Paul, how he got converted and was willing to serve you, how Timothy was trained as a young person, gave his life to God to preach, to serve you, and how Lydia got converted, the first convert in Europe, and we're so thankful we can trace our history back to these moments. We pray, Lord, for boys and girls tonight who are not saved. We pray, Lord, you'll call them, you'll save them, and they'll be like Lydia, and they'll respond and be wonderful people of God. In your loving name we pray. Amen. See you.